Dolby Vision has been around for a few years now. The brightness and contrast the HDR format is able to provide is considered the industry standard. However, the brightest white and darkest blacks shown on your TV panels can still be lost by a constant enemy in your environment: ambient light. In this video, Movie University sits down with Head of Consumer Audio Playback and Broadcast at Dolby Laboratories. When Dolby Vision was announced in 2014, it caused quite a stir. The increased detail provided by the high dynamic range format seemed almost rapturous and offered studios and content creators alike another level of depth and detail with which to tell stories. As Dolby Vision began to become more and more widespread, problems began to surface with audiences of some content saying Dolby Vision was too bright or too dark, such as the case with the House of Dragons series finale. To combat this, Dolby released Dolby Vision IQ in 2021. This new version of the HDR format includes technology which utilizes a television's sensors to automatically control and adjust the brightness of a TV panel for a room's environment.
Dolby Vision IQ is a product that we have developed for TV manufacturers to have an option for improving the experience that a consumer has when they receive Dolby Vision content. It is using information that exists in the Dolby Vision stream specifically to make choices about the content type. There are different requirements that a TV would apply to content that is, for example, audiovisual content like a movie or a TV show, compared to content that is a game or graphics. When you think about games that are available in Dolby Vision, you want to make sure that they are displayed at the highest possible speed. You don't want to have a lot of latency, and we are talking about milliseconds here. We're not talking about a longer latency, but you want to make sure that basically a game is processed at the with the lowest possible latency, and Dolby Vision IQ allows for that. Another process that we have introduced is if a TV has light sensors about the ambient light, we can actually apply that information from those light sensors on the TV for the way how the vision image, the Dolby Vision image, is rendered on the television set as well. So you have kind of an environmental awareness, if you like, of the television set, and that then is applied to the image as such. And then we also have on top of the overall Dolby Vision rendering, an opportunity that allows a post-process done to the individual images, which helps with edges, for example. It sharpens the edges a little bit, which means you get a more dimensional, a three-dimensional picture, because you have clearer delineations between different color areas. Those are solutions that sit on top of the HDR and the Dolby Vision process. In other words, they are specific to the TV model and the TV manufacturer. They are an addition that we saw interest from the market. So we were developing and innovating along those lines as well. They are not specific to, I mean, they use information from the Dolby Vision file, but they are not specific to HDR. They go beyond what HDR as such does, because they are not relevant for, as I said, the color space, nor are they relevant for the how the brightness between black and white, for example, is displayed.
Dolby Vision IQ isn't widespread just yet. Just like all new technology, it's currently predominantly available in the higher-end televisions, and it'll eventually filter down to other TVs and devices as time goes on.
It is today in a number of our Dolby Vision models from a number of our TV partners. It's the choice of the TV partner. It is something where a TV OEM that has very in-depth knowledge of imaging technologies could have a competitive product as well. We haven't tried to put something to market that is the one you have for every OEM. We were filling an industry demand, we were filling a gap in the market from OEMs that don't have the research capability, that don't have the engineering know-how to do some of that additional processing beyond HDR on their television models. Those are the partners that we are aiming to engage with. Those we have been successfully engaged with. Choices is theirs. If they decide that they want to have Dolby Vision IQ across their whole range, great. That works very well for us. But when you think about what I said earlier, for example, ambient light responsiveness requires their respective light sensors on a TV, and those sensors tend to be more on the higher end TVs, less on the lower end TVs, because they obviously have a cost associated with them. So we currently see Dolby Vision IQ coming to market on the lower, on the higher end of the TV range, not so much on the lower end, and we don't anticipate that it will be as widely deployed as Dolby Vision as such.
This is Movie University, education in cinema.